Partyville senior Angie Banks is the 2013 Portage Register Girls Basketball Player of the Year. Angie, you've had quite a career in basketball, or in all sports, actually, in Partyville there. Your story kind of starts back like 8 years ago. It was almost a tragedy. Tell us what happened some people probably don't know this, but you're legally blind in your left eye. Tell us kind of just how that happened.
When I was in fourth grade, I was coming home from a school function, and it was really snowy out, and there was some black ice, and our car slipped on it, and we spun around, and we went into a utility pole, and right where we hit the pole was right where I was sitting, and I hit my head and fractured my skull and pinched my optic nerve.
So I'm assuming you spent some time in the hospital and stuff like that. Like, how serious was all that at the time?
It was pretty serious. I had a big... they were going to med flight me, but the roads were so bad, or it was so bad out, they couldn't. So I had to take an ambulance down to UW Children's Hospital. And they really didn't care about my eye when I was there. They were more worried about my head because I got blood on my brain. But then afterwards, they just kind of came in on the last day before I left. They just kind of told me that you're blind in your eye and there's really nothing you can do. So they're like, they really advised me not to play sports just to protect my other eye, but I told them I was going to prove them wrong. So
right. And then what's just been like? I mean, it's playing sports and excelling at sports can be tough enough, and here you're basically doing it in one eye. What kind of challenge is that for an athlete?
Sometimes it's frustrating, like in basketball, sometimes on defense, like if I didn't see someone. But I never use it as an excuse. I just tell myself that I just need to work harder and just try to see the player. I don't know. I don't really like taking no for an answer or telling, like, I hate when people feel sorry for me that I'm blind in one eye. I mean, it's really not that big of a deal. There's nothing I can do about it. So I just go out there and do my thing and work hard like everyone else.
Yeah, it's something I'm sure most people have no clue. I mean, they watch you play and you would never know it just watching you play, and you look just like a normal kid. So, yeah, like you say, you're just a normal kid out there playing, right?
Yeah, then I'll wear goggles to protect my eye, and sometimes, like, other schools will, like, chant, like, goggles, and I just laugh because they don't know why I have them on. So
sure.
It just kind of motivates me to prove them that why I have them.
And now, basically, your high school basketball career kind of just wrapped up not too long ago. What, when you look back at it, what's your favorite memory of the time you in high school hoops?
I don't know. There's a lot of, like, cool, like, games-wise, there's a lot of cool, but as, like, a freshman to, like, as a senior playing on varsity, it's, I don't know, just so much has changed. Like, just growing as a team and learning so much about, like, other players and how I should be playing. It's just, I don't know, it's more of a learning experience, and I'm really grateful that I got to get 4 years out of it.
Your senior year this year was kind of a hectic year. You know, you guys coming into the season, your leading scorer was Morgan Jerome, another senior, and she leaves the team midway through. What was it like just, you know, losing, you know, such a good player like Morgan and then kind of having to move on from that point?
It kind of was just shocking that what happened, but we just kind of told ourselves, like, well, we just need to pick it up, and she was a good player, now we just need to play our role and take over her spot and just play harder as a team.
And as you kind of move on to college, what will you miss, maybe not just about basketball, but high school athletics as a whole when you're in college?
Just like the whole community, like everyone who like come to our games and support us and like going to school and just talking about it with your friends. I don't know, it was just a cool experience. And like going to like Piggly Wiggly or Quick Trip, just having like, hey, nice game last night. Like, it's just cool having such a close community that really get into sports.
And you mentioned earlier that you're going to go to MATC and you're going to try to play some sports there, hopefully?
Yeah, hopefully.
Well, I appreciate your time, and thanks for coming in and talking to us today.
Yeah, thank you very much.
You bet.